Hello, this is Andrew, and in this video, number 15, I show you how to build a wooden boat using techniques often used for making wood strip canoes. With glue, staples, and fiberglass for the next stages in the future videos of this series. I teach you how to create the unique shapes from the wooden hull frames using the long wood strips from stem to stern. I begin on the port side first using Gorilla Glue and water to bond the strips. The hull will be fine-tuned with bondo and sanded smooth, then painted and covered with fiberglass and epoxy resin to make everything watertight and seaworthy. I experiment with Gorilla Glue in my very first boat to see just how well it adapts to the curves of the unique hull design. Soon I need to start taking apart the electric trolling motor to look at mounting the electric powered motor under the hull, which will be powered by two deep cycle marine batteries, since I purchased a 24 volt marine system for freshwater only. Hello, my name is Andrew Jones, Artistic Brit on YouTube. As my first small boat design, I want to build something that was sturdy, strong, and seaworthy. Something that pushed me and my woodworking abilities, but a watercraft that would help me learn as I continued with the build. I already have made so many adjustments and mistakes in building this boat, called the Heron, but have adjusted the plans and patterns for the next time I cut the plywood sheets to make my second version of this boat. My goal is to create a series of boat plans to sell cheaply on my website, proven plans with a beautifully handcrafted design based on pleasing aesthetics. I am even thinking about selling pre-cut wood kits to help you make the boat from my how-to instruction manual. And of course, don't forget that by liking this series of videos, by liking each and every video that comes out, you are automatically entered to win this actual 8 foot long electric powered boat. Good luck.
Adjust marks the bow where, flies. I just marked the bow where I need to sand down and add the angle so the two pieces can butt up nicely. It's almost there. So I'm going to release these clamps, let it come up and sand it down.
I've spritzed it down yet again with some water. I think I'm just gonna let it sit. I'd rather it kind of dry a little bit in this position so that when I do cut it, when I cut down this line, that it doesn't add extra foreign forces to it that it's not already used to. If I kind of pre-bend it and dampen it like this, at least the fibers will kind of dry a little bit more in this direction. So I'm going to leave it probably for about an hour as it dries. And then I'll take this side off and prepare for gluing. I'm going to get my oscillating saw and rest it on the upper lip inside, come through from the other side, but before I actually meet the line. So I'm going to come through about here and see where the line matches up. If it matches up, I don't know. I'm just kind of thinking it through bit by bit. I'm going to see first where that is matching up to the pattern that I have drawn on this wood. And from there, I'll kind of know my next steps. So let's see what I got. I don't know, I think that that line is higher than
I drew it. I've zoomed in onto the hull where I think the line is going to be projected, that top pencil line. So what I'm going to do, actually I think what I am going to do is drill a very small hole. Yeah, it came out just below that pencil line. So I'm glad I didn't cut this yet. So the straight line from here to here didn't do it. So that hole's nothing. So I think what I'm gonna do is let this dry. I don't know, probably let it dry overnight. Let it kind of take the shape a little bit more. On the other side, when I actually did this, when it bent over this bit, it cracked just a little bit because I carved off this little section. And because I carved this off, it created a weakness. So two things different this time. I'm using these blocks to spread the pressure. I'm going to leave this on to the last minute, and then I will cut this bit off first. So I'll cut this off, but I think I'm going to take this clamp off because it's going to be too big. It's too large. I'll put on a smaller clamp here, wheel it inside the garage, and tomorrow glue it in place. The starboard side, actually the starboard side fairing, has been drying. It was just a surface dampening anyway, but it's certainly going to help maintain those curves when I take this out tomorrow. Here's a goofy thing, but I love it. The top of this is probably at eye level. And it's just a rag dispenser, paper towels, and I think there's 200. towels. It's just great being able, it's the silly things that we take for granted, you know, being able to walk into the workshop, grab some towels, and get on with your day. I got this, I don't know, like a bit like a utility knife of sorts, but it's like it's not exactly bushcraft. It has a chisel point on it as well. Extremely sharp. Made in Sweden, carbon. I've heard that if you get them wet, they do have a propensity to rust a little bit, so not the highest quality, but wow, is this sharp.
So I've got three in, they're holding them even. This up here is getting cut out. So I'm just kind of letting it expand. And as it pushes past the level area, I'm kind of wiping it dry. What I did was I put some glue on my finger and I pushed it into the joint behind. I'm going to let that cure overnight. I'm just going to come in through the other side, give it a little spritz. It's nice because with this I can direct the nozzle to be pretty direct instead of a wide spray. I let the glue settle and dry, and the glue actually that I put in from the other side has come out quite nicely. I'm cutting the top piece here, so I'm not too worried about what goes on that way. But these lined up pretty nice. So this was the stuff that I was more interested in. And I think I'm going to take these out. So this is the inside view. So I'm just going to wet it with some liberal squirts just to kind of get the area. That's the moisture aspect. And now I'm going to go ahead and put some glue on that piece of wood that I showed you, and you'll see it right here. You know, I don't know what was recording now and what wasn't, but there is, that's the back piece of wood that is gluing, and around here is the other side of it. And like I said, when I cut it, I'll be cutting around about here, but I just need a piece of wood behind it securely, kind of giving it some adhesion. You know, I could use the Japanese pull saw to cut along here, but I like the control also I have with this, with the oscillating tool. So I'm gonna kind of go for it and see what I end up with. I actually started to sand down, cut down and then sand down the, this is the Gorilla Glue. And again, it's not meant to be any form of adhesion. It was sealed pretty much all the way along anyway. I just wanted to fill the gaps. I'm probably now going to just put some epoxy on that. Let it dry and sand it. You know, I was gonna put another strip of wood, ply, but I'm actually putting a wider, I don't know if it would be a chine or an outer keel. I don't know technically what it would be known as, but I'll probably put a piece of wood like this wide. It will cross the open keel space, but it'd probably be like 3/4 of an inch on this side, 3/4 of an inch on the other side for almost the entire length of the boat. This arch, I'm gonna have to make a pattern of this little bit of the arch right here, copy it onto 3 pieces of wood, and then bring it to the forward 3 frames, because if you see, there's too much gap between the frame and where the side of the bow fairing is. And then this one too, again, it's too far away, so by the time I start the arch at the bottom and here, terminate it up here, both sides, I'll be able to rest it up against a piece of the wood, which would be the side of the frame. And then once I've done that, I'll take a new pattern from these forward frames that I had to adjust. You see now the new transition on the first, second frames, or the penultimate and the last frame, let's say. So I've cut eight strips. I didn't really measure them, but they're about 3/4 inch wide. I'll measure them in a minute. And then what I'm doing is putting them butt up against the top. I'm putting them butt up against the top, which is the lower fairing, making sure it's straight, holding it. Then behind. I overcut on this line slightly, so I'm going to see how much that matters. I'm going to sand this down a little bit just to clean it up, but just enough to kind of deburr it. Again, I need more practice on the bandsaw.